In the news today, is Britney making Fred Durst go soft? Limp Bizkit revealed details of the new album, MTV News meets Electric Six, and Gwyneth and Chris Martin in public. Believe it or not, but Fred Durst and Britney Spears are said to be an item. On Limp Bizkit's official website, Fred tells us Britney is a good judge of character like himself, and he doesn't believe he's ever felt this way about anyone before. The star writes that you can't help what happens in life because everything happens for a reason. But fans can rest and relax as the hard man of new metal assures us he hasn't turned into a complete romantic. Fred dares fans to believe he's going soft until they hear the new album, which he revealed is only four tracks from completion. Apart from giving Britney a bit of loving, the frontman has been gearing up for the release of the band's first single, Crack Addict. He used three choice words to describe it in a recent interview, which I'm afraid MTV News can't repeat. The band still haven't found a suitable replacement for departed guitarist Wes Borland, but they certainly aren't letting it worry them. The Biscuits are extremely excited about their collaborations with such music industry legends as Korn's Brian Head Welsh, The Neptunes, and Weezer's Rivers Cuomo. Fans are set to be able to get their eager hands on Limp Bizkit's new album this April. MTV caught up with the Detroit posse Electric Six as they promote their new single, Danger High Voltage.
I was playing guitar one day with a pedal in it, a delay pedal, echo pedal. I grabbed I hit the wrong button, it started going da-na-na-na, da-na-na-na.
Fire in the disco!
The lyrics just sort of came to me in the shower. That was somebody I was dating at the time it was shot.
It's over now.
I had kind of a May December thing going.
Yeah.
It's my desire. Danger, danger. No, we're still very good friends, and yeah, I moved on now. And the moose is gone too.
Divine inspiration.
Yeah. I redecorate every so often.
What keeps us going.
Yeah. If you can't laugh at the end of the day, then what do you really have?
Despite tension remaining between Blur and estranged Graham Coxon, bass player Alex James has admitted that he recently met up with him. It's revealed that the pair met up for a friendly chat, describing the occasion as simply all right. Despite the meeting, James said nothing about the possibility of Coxon. This is MTV News. For more, check out www.mtve.com.
Hey, thank you for tuning in. It's really appreciated, because if you weren't watching, we wouldn't be able to play the best videos and musicians who live, sweat, and suffer for their output. And that is exactly what we're here to do, so let's get started. Here are some very good reasons why you should stay with us for the next 60 minutes. The Raveonettes, the Datsuns, Underworld, Liam Lynch, Electric Six, and Mogwai. But first, it's us. They're ready with a second single from Life on Other Planets, and it's called Seen the Light. The song's a bit of a retro rocker, and even more so than usual for the trio. You see, it's even been a big influence on the video. Have a look.
Here's some
rock and roll worshipping like it could only happen in the good. Supergrass have definitely seen the light. Made You Look is taken from the latest Nas album, God's Son. Before that, it was Supergrass, Seen the Light. Next, proof that luckily not everyone is as musically damaged as us MTV employees. Truth be told, we fight TVs turned up to the maximum, playing the latest novelty pop on a daily basis. Still, no matter how hard we try to avoid and ignore them, the songs of Avril, Shakira, and those chop chicks still manage to haunt us in our sleep. In comparison, the Datsuns seem to enjoy a completely different world. Singer Dolph de Datsun was recently quizzed whether he preferred Pink or Kelly Osbourne. His answer was as follows, and I quote here, "I prefer neither because I don't know who one of them is, and the other I don't really want to think about either. None of them has anything to do with me or us. I don't understand." How refreshing. Now, critics might claim that the Datsuns are taking refuge in 70s rock heaven, but hey, isn't that better than pop hell? Some food for thought there while we watch Harmonic Generator.
You ever wonder at what point you gotta stop living up here and start living down here?
On this week's Making the Movie, Eminem raids his closet to star in his very own hip-hop Rocky, 8 Mile.
Let's do it.
Join us as we exclusively go one-on-one with thespian Marshall Mathers, who faces the challenge that has knocked out many a rapper before him. Acting. MTV, Making the Movie, 8 Mile. 9:30 and 6:30 Saturday on MTV.
MTV at the Movies is sponsored by Tiscali, the European internet company.
Hello?
It's real, John.
If whatever John Klein is experiencing...
99 will die.
...is all in his mind...
What happened to my wife?
You
didn't see it, did you?
Would you know my name? Losing my religion. Those were the best days.
MTV Unplugged, ute nu.
Har ni något som inte är så förbannat dyrt?
Vårt nya salsa king meal kostar bara 39 kronor.
Jaha.
Det innehåller sallad, salsasås, majonnäs och nygrillat nötkött.
Caramba! Quieres bailar? Salsa King Meal, gott och billigt.
We're back in the green. Now, you might not recognize the name Liam Lynch, but there's a good chance you're familiar with some of his work. You see, he was the guy who invented MTV cult shows Ollie in the 90s, and he's also done several commercials and even music videos for the likes of Tenacious D and others. Lynch's latest venture goes into pop music. After 3 years of stints in Liverpool, Great Britain, he returned to the US and suffered a bit of a culture shock. He decided to make a song about it, and apparently United States of Whatever took about as long to write as it takes to perform or listen to. In other words, 1 minute and 26 seconds. Now that's what I call efficiency. The single inspired Lynch to write more songs, and recently, or maybe just an hour later, finished a whole album, which is scheduled for release later this year. United States of Whatever became a cult hit when it was released in the UK in December. It even made it into the top 20, so it's to sing along to the lo-fi punk tune. This has the some more times, which is good because it's hilarious. Have a look, or whatever. From Underworld. The video was made for their new single, Dinosaur Adventure 3D. And before that, you had Liam Lynch and United States of Whatever. The Raveonettes are a new act from Denmark. The duo was formed by guitarist and singer, bassist and singer Sharon Fu. The Raveonettes make retro, plenty of noisy guitars of the Jesus and Mary chain, the vocal harmonies of 60s girl groups, instrumental surf, and 50s rock and roll. The ideas employed by the Danish Dogma movement in cinema, Raveonettes used a similar minimalist strategy when writing their debut Whip It On. They only used a very basic set of instruments. They wrote and recorded all the material in the key of B flat minor, and all the songs are short and to the result is a very focused mini album. And after it was released on local Danish indie label Frog last spring, the Raveonettes were subject of a bidding war with lots of major labels. They decided to go with Columbia, and the Sony imprint are soon re-releasing Whip It On around the world. The first single from the album is Attack of the Ghost Riders, and here it is with some visuals paying homage to B-movies of the 1950s.
Begun. This is a new era. Time to access the future. During 1 hour, you select what we play. You have total access. Use the whole archive. Let the world know that this is your choice. Your music, your name. Tools given to you. Go to mtve.com/access. Watch Access, weekdays at 3 on MTV.
Melody Cat. Efter stor turné och två hitsinglar släpper nu Music Club sitt debutalbum Music Machine. Music Machine finns i skivbutikerna nu.
Melanie has a great future.
Marry me.
But back home in Alabama,
hey,
she's rediscovering her past.
Hey.
Now.
Can he swim?
Doesn't look like it.
One woman has to choose.
What I need to know is if there is a place for me in your future.
Between two loves.
Nobody finds a soulmate when they're 10 years old, right?
And two worlds.
I'm really happy in New York.
But this fits too.
Reese Witherspoon, Sweet Home Alabama.
Oh, a lamp. Excellent.
Hey, stop it. That tickles. Thanks, Aladdin. That lamp was cramping my style. Have three wishes on me.
Oh, cool. Then I wish to be as smart as a fox, mm-hmm. as big as a bull, mm-hmm. and fly like an eagle.
Then you need a Red Bull, Aladdin. It's stimulation for body and mind.
Wow! Red Bull gives you wings. Mm. You're a genius. I'm out of here.
Who's going to rub me down? No!
Come here.
Well, that should be enough commercial fodder for now, so let's get on with more of the show. And the freaky new Electric Six single, Danger, High Voltage. If you watched our shows in December, you might have heard Joanne talk about how one of the people shouting passionately on this song is Jack White from the White Stripes. We're about 99.999977 recurring percent certain of this, even though Electric Six deny that Jack has ever recorded anything with them. Instead, the five men, who by strange coincidence come from White Stripes City, Detroit, claim the singer is a local car mechanic called John S. O'Leary. Now, we don't know if Jack White ever has been big for repairs, but he certainly is local, and John S. O'Leary is one of his aliases. A good guess why Electric Six won't admit this connection is that they could be seen as compromising as a new band deliberately making use of a cool alternative music icon on their first international single. Of course, there's also the alternative that we're overanalyzing, in which case the explanation is that Electric Six is too mad to even realize the truth and remember who visited them in the studio. Anyway, let's see what it's all about. Here's the track that not only has the potential to spawn a whole new disco metal movement, but also puts a spark back into every weak heart. Danger, High Voltage. Well, it's time for us to leave you on this Tuesday night. Sad but true, but I promise there'll be more Green TV tomorrow night. In the meantime, please make use of mtve.com to get more information on this issue. Tonight, I'll play out with German dance producer Mogwai, not to be confused with Scottish rock band Mogwai. Behind this dancey version of the Mogwai moniker, we find DJ producer called Andre Tegeler. He's got a new single out called You Know Why, and just like the song, the video is also rather funky. Have a great night. Bye.
MTV Source is the show where your favorite artists pick their favorite artists. Saturdays and Sundays at 7.